Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. We're going to continue our work with even and odd functions, and we do the following five problems on this video. All right, so here's the first problem. Go ahead and put the video on pause and try it on your own first. All right, so what we need to do is see what happens when we plug in negative x for x. We have to do f of negative x. So we plug in negative x in place of all the x's. Now remember, if our answer ends up being f of x, the same thing, remember that means it's even. And if our answer is negative x, that means it's odd, and if neither of those things happens, it's neither. So just keep in mind, that's a little remember, when you plug in f of negative x, if you get the original function, it's an even function, and if you get negative f of x, the opposite, right? All the terms would be opposite. If it was just one term, then we would have an odd function. Okay, so what happens here? Well, I've got my minus x in the numerator. In the denominator, I've got a negative x cubed and a plus 2x. So we have to decide, is that the same function or is it the opposite function or is it neither? And this is a little bit tricky because when you first look at it, it doesn't look exactly the same. So how about if I factor out a negative 1 out of the numerator and a negative 1 out of the denominator? So this is a tricky problem. So negative x, remember, is the same thing as negative 1, right, times x. And if I factor out a negative 1 out of the denominator, I have x cubed minus 2x. So notice those negative 1s cancel. And I end up with x over x cubed minus 2x. That's the original function. That's exactly f of x. So this is an even function. Let's see, I'm going to just write even. And it's symmetric with the y-axis. Okay, so we're going to graph this. There's going to be symmetry with the y-axis. Now, this is confusing. A lot of people look at this fraction here and they say, well, at the top everything's at the opposite, at the bottom everything's the opposite, so this must be an odd function. Well, that's not true. Let's just take a simple example. Take the number 8 over 1. All right, now let's just take the opposite of the top and the opposite of the bottom. That's actually exactly the same number, isn't it? It's still 8 over 1. It's not the opposite. So if you've got the opposite of the numerator and the opposite of the denominator, you're back to your original. So this one is worth thinking about and looking at again if that isn't obvious to you yet. Okay? So be careful here. This is just one term, and in one term, you can't have the opposite of the top and the opposite of the bottom and say the whole thing's opposite. All right, here's another tricky one. See if you can figure this out on your own first. So we're going to do f of negative x. So we're going to plug in negative x for x. And we're going to plug in negative x for x over here. And the question is this the same or not? Well, this also is pretty tricky. This absolute value of negative x minus x, right? When you simplify this. And you know what? This, let's see, this is actually the same as this. So think about any number you want. If you take the absolute value, sorry, forgot to change my pen. Absolute value of, let's take 3 is really the same thing as the absolute value of negative 3. So that's really the same. But then this plus x over here, and I got a minus x over here, that makes things different. So it's not exactly the same function, and it's also not exactly the opposite of that function. And to convince yourself further of this, what you could do is plug in some numbers, right? So let x equal 2, for instance. So the question is this. If you're going to plug in f of 2, what do you get? You get the absolute value of 2 plus 2, which is 4. And then let's plug in the absolute value of negative 2. You get negative 2 plus 2. I'm sorry. Plus negative 2. I forgot to plug in. I'm plugging in negative 2. Okay, absolute value of negative 2 is 2, and 2 plus negative 2 is 0. So notice when I plugged in f of negative 2, I did not get the same number, and I did not get the opposite number, so therefore this is neither. So both of these are tricky problems so far. Right, next one. Try this on your own. It's not as tricky. Okay, so again, we're going to plug in f of negative x. So we're plugging in negative x for every value. Every time we see an x, we're plugging in a negative x. All right, so when you square this negative x, we get a 3x squared. Having trouble writing today. Over x to the fourth minus 5. Now, this negative x squared is also an x squared. Is it the same function? Yes, it is. Nice not to have a tricky one. So this is an even function, right? And it's symmetric with the y-axis. All right, last one. Again, put the video on pause, try it on your own first. So we're going to plug in negative x for x. So we have to figure out f of negative x. All right, so we have a negative x squared plus 9 times negative x. We have a negative x squared plus 9. So in the numerator, we have x squared minus 9x. In the denominator, we have x squared plus 9. So if you look in the numerator is not the same, and it's also not the opposite. So without even considering the denominator, if the numerator isn't either at least one or the other, it's not going to work out. So this also is neither. So this was not, so we had a few that were not. Were neither, right? Neither even nor odd. You might have noticed if all the terms have an even exponent, then more likely to be an even function. For instance, I have an x squared term and 9, a constant is considered to be an even function because you could write that as 9x to the 0 power, 9 times 1. But you know what threw off everything here? X to the first power. So if you have a mixture of odd and even exponents, all right, you got to be more careful. Usually the answer is going to be neither. I want to say usually because there could be some weird way the problem is set up. Maybe there's some square roots or absolute values that might change things a little bit. Right, here's a bonus problem. So we're going to plug in negative x for x. So we have 5 times the negative x cubed. We have 2 times the negative x squared plus 9. So in the numerator, this negative x to the third power is going to make the whole thing negative, right? So I'm just going to write it that way. Negative 5x cubed over 2x squared plus 9. So, is this the same as f of x? No, it's not. Is it the opposite? Yes, it is. If just the numerator is the opposite, then and the denominator is the same, it's the opposite. So I could write this as a negative out in front, right? 2x squared plus 9. This is exactly what I was talking about. Be careful. You see an x cubed, you also see an x squared, you see an odd and an even function. But it's if one's in the numerator and a different one's in the denominator, then things are different. So if you had a plus x squared up here, then you would have a problem. So if it's either both in the numerator or both in the denominator. So what do we have here? Finally, this is the same thing as negative f of x. So this is an odd function and it's symmetric with the origin. All right, so we've done lots and lots of problems in determining whether functions are even or odd, and that can be very helpful, especially when you're graphing. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.